You ready? Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another edition of Exciting Panther Basketball. We're live here in the William Nix Center. The Panther Sports Broadcast team compiled Mr. JT Beard, Mia Greer, and yours truly, Charles Porter, getting ready for Exciting Panther Basketball. The Panthers are taking on the Tigers of Jackson State. Man, it's going to be a fierce battle. The Jackson State Tigers are coming in, ladies and gentlemen, really, really hot, folks. So as we get ready to take on the starting lineup for the Jackson State Tigers, we'll let you know we got some scenarios going here, and it's going to be really, really interesting down the stretch, folks, as the Panthers get ready to head to the tournament. Mathematically, Prairie View A&M University is in the tournament, and we are going to – you got to get my okay, Prairie View is in the tournament, and we'll break down these scenarios here in just a few moments, folks. The starting lineup for the Tigers of Jackson State, Tiana Bowler is a senior from Meridian, Mississippi. Maya Crump from right down the street, Houston, Texas. Jack Yates product will get the start at the point guard. Angel Jackson will be the graduate, post player. Ariana Hunter is a junior from Louisville, Mississippi, and from Oakland, California. It's going to be Sakia Mahoney, the head coach for the Tigers of Jackson State, is Tamika Reed. Her assistants, LaShonda Cousin, Chase Campbell, and Jonathan Winters, ladies and gentlemen. Very, very interesting game tonight. The Panthers are struggling here, folks, to try to keep that sixth-place position. If they can keep that sixth-place position, they'll be right where they want to be. They'll play Alabama A&M or either Bethune-Cookman or FAMU. The scenario is still being unfolded. So, folks, we're going to have to watch to see how everything is going to go, how the Panthers are going to fare tonight, and also how the other teams will fare. Alcorn's down the street at Texas Southern. We need them to lose to Texas Southern. If Texas Southern gets it back together, that'll put us in sole position of sixth place. Where's my piece of paper here? With a loss with FAMU and Bethune-Cookman. FAMU's been down. Maybe Bethune-Cookman can get them and keep the Panthers in that sixth place. Starting lineup for your Lady Panthers, a senior from New Orleans, Louisiana. Actually, LaPlace, Louisiana. The 5'9 redshirt senior, Michaela, in the clutch, Hutchinson. Also starting, the graduate student from Los Angeles, California, Ryan Payne at the point guard. Jalen Smith, the senior from Miramar, Florida, will get the start at the forward. Jessica Sodas will be on her wing at forward. And in the middle, the freshman from North Little Rock will be Amari Williams. The head coach for your Prairie View University Lady Panthers is Sandy Pugh. Her assistants, Danny Evans, David Frank, Jeanette Jackson, and Coach Rhonda, help me, Rhonda Jackson. Should be an interesting game here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Want to thank all of you who are watching and listening. We'll take a quick break and come back. We'll take a quick break, a quick one, to come back with the tip-off. This is Exciting Panther Sports.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School.
Joe Jackson.
Will put the Panthers on the board. Folks, if you want to see the video, if you want to see the video, those of you on Splendid Media listening and watching, you'll have to go to the Prairie View and Dim Athletics YouTube page. You can get all the video and you can get all the background music and all of the good stuff if you go to the YouTube page. 20-foot jump shot. I think that was Crump that hit that one, and we'll go back the other way with the Panthers now. 4:27:59 left to play here in the first quarter. Smith with a 20-footer from the left wing. No good. The rebound snatched down by Jackson, and the Tigers now brings it into the forecourt. Hunter kicks it right side to Bowler. She'll shoot it up. No good. Smith gets the rebound. Good job, and we're going back now the other way with Ryan Payne. Payne crosses over, working on Mia Crump. Steps back, thought about it from the elbow. Gives it out in the corner to Hutch in the clutch for three. Oh, yeah. I like that one. She shot that one from LaPlace. That's for sure. Want to send a shout out to the Hutchinson family and friends in LaPlace, Louisiana, listening to exciting Panther sports. Crump takes it from the right corner and goes out of bounds off the foot of Hutchinson, up off the board quickly for the Jackson State Tigers. Adriana Avent, the redshirt senior from Sacramento, California. Bowler getting a little chew, left side with it. Crump now gets up, puts it up, and shoots it up for two. It's good. And Tamika Reed showing Tamika Reed over there. Left side with it. Smith now over to Payne. 7-5. The Tigers up on the Panthers by one. Here comes Payne at the free throw line. Hits the front of the iron. It rolls right side. Chased down by Mahoney. And Mahoney will kick it over to Hunter. Hunter takes it baseline. Smith's going to be called on the ground for it. Or are they going to go right side and say Williams? Yeah, Williams battling there right side with post player Angel Jackson. That time Jackson winning the battle and drawing the foul on the floor away from the ball. The Panthers will stay on defense. 24 seconds on the shot clock here. Quick pass inside. Mahoney trying to muscle her way in. Good defense there by Williams and Soders. Payne working on Hunter, drops it down, looking for Williams, coming over the back of Williams. That time was Angel Jackson. She'll be flagged for the foul. It's two on the Tigers here. Another tray will be, it's two or one? What do you got? One foul on the Jackson State Tigers? Okay, they waved the other foul out, so you got a foul apiece on both sides. Hutch to take it out. Hutchinson look inside. Williams, man, with a little muscle, gets it on the right left block. Turns, twist on Jackson, puts it off the glass for two. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Tied at seven here. 6:16 left to play. Right side, Mahoney. Kicks it over in the corner now to Avant. And Avant back to Jackson. It looks like we're going to have a tit for tat here with Williams. And Jackson should be good, folks. Payne. Soders in the corner. Back over now to Hutchinson. Now back over to Payne to set up the offense. 9-7, two-point edge by the Tigers of Jackson State. Left side with it. Williams working on Mahoney. Gives it up to Hutchinson. Hutchinson working on Avon. Gives it back now to Williams. Williams puts it up and gets a little body with it. And we're going back the other way. Kashana Luckett snuck in on us, the graduate student from right there in Jackson, Mississippi. And the Tigers are just loaded, folks. Here comes Hutchinson, kicks it back right side, wide open, paint for three, looks good. No, it's off the mark. Chased down by Soders, and Soders trying to get it, grabs it, skips it now to Williams, down to 16 seconds on the shot clock. Williams now trying to make something happen. Soders gets it. Good heads-up basketball by the Panthers. And here comes Payne on the baseline. Gets a birdie. Puts it up from 15. Yeah, we like it. Tied at 9. The Panthers playing great here in the early going. Here comes Luckett on the left side. She'll run the point. Going around Mahoney. Cut off by Williams. Back over to Mahoney. Mahoney with a jump shot. Oh, loses it. Recovers. Gets it back. Turns around from 15. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Here comes Hutchinson with it. Hutch down to Soders. And looks like, was that 10? Did someone get a hold to it? And it stays for the Panthers. Yeah, mass substitution. Here comes Lewis. And here comes Roberson along with Waddle and Smith. And looks like it's going to come up with a timeout, ladies and gentlemen. Man, the Panthers doing great here in the first half. 4:34 left to play here in the first quarter. We're tied at 9. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M Panthers Sports Broadcast Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool your school. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Had an issue with the mixer. Here we go back to live action. Smith will have it. Now Roberson in the right corner. Back over to Kayla Smith on the wing. So Roberson with that dribble drive loses it, and it's snatched out of her hands by Layla Walker, the sophomore from Gulfport, Mississippi. The Panthers come down with it. It's Soders into the hands of Ryan Payne, and now the Lady Panthers wants to work. Payne working on Bowler. Puts it up. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Bowler chases it down. Now we're going back. Red to the Jackson State side. 3:57 left to play here in the first. Luckett brings it right side. Just goes right around Soders and under Waddle for an easy two. 11-9, a two-point edge. The Panthers keeping it close here in the first quarter. Payne to Waddle at the top of the key down to Soders. Bad pass, but the Panthers are bailed out with a foul. Adriana Avon got a little arm there. And the Panther, Tigers aren't very happy with that call. Haley Breland, this junior from Newton, Mississippi, we'll check in and give Avant a breather. The Panthers doing pretty darn good here, ladies and gentlemen, with one turnover in the first quarter. The Tigers with one turnover in the first quarter. The Panthers, man, have been doing pretty poorly in the turnover category with an average of 20. Have significantly cut that one out. And going up for the shot there was Lewis. And catching Lewis on the hand there was Layla Walker, the sophomore from Gulfport. Is that three? Let's check it out here as Jackson comes back in. Yeah, three team fouls now on the Tigers with 3:18 left to play. And here comes the snack lady. Wow. I'm referring to our sports information director who's been taking pretty good care of us this year on the snack side. I'm just telling you, first shot is away from Lewis. It's good. Again, for those of you watching on the Splendid Portion Network, some of y'all are mad because my head is so big right here in the screen. But if you want to watch the video, our deal is that we can do the pregame and all of that. But when it comes to the live action during the game, we've got to turn it back over to the Prairie View University Broadcast Network. Go on over there. We need the views, man. Tell a friend to tell 10 friends about to tell 10 about exciting Panther basketball, women's basketball, on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network. Crump for three. Yeah. Don't want her getting hot. The Panthers now still keeping it close. 14-11 the score. 2:57 left to play here in the first quarter. Williams will have it right wing. Jackson will come out and meet her. They'll give it back now left side to Lewis. Lewis goes around. Crump, great move. Puts it off the glass. No. And Jackson will have it and kicking it to the hands of Luckett. Luckett brings it up left side. Back up top to Crump. Dribble drive. Turns it right side. Gives it inside now to, well, tries to go inside, but keeps it in Breland's hand. Breland gives it back up now to Luckett with 16 seconds. She kicks it in the corner. Wide open for three. We've got to defend that. Is Haley Breland and the Panthers going after it. Here comes. No, they're both going after the ball. The Jackson State Tigers will take it. The Jackson State Tigers will take over that one. If you look at it, folks, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to snap at you, JT. Please forgive me. Here's the shot right here. The three-point shot is off. And going forward, there's Ryan Payne going and diving forward and getting to the ground, but had too much on it. Please forgive me. I didn't mean that there. 2:21 left to play here in the first. I'll acquiesce that to my liege here. And, oh, what a nice shot by Bowler, who goes around the entire defense, sneaks in on the left side off the block, and gets it on the glass. Now the Tigers with their largest lead of the game, 5-16-11. Soders off the bench. Payne says, hey, no way. She almost hit that one. Payne trying to keep it close. Let Panthers need to clamp down on defense. Bowler looking for it on the right side. Coming down the wing. Here comes Luckett. She'll put it off the glass. No. And over the back of Luckett. It should go the other way. Are they going to call that one against three? Oh, they give that one against Soders. 31, 32. What are you doing? 32. Soders under the bucket pushing and shoving. And Kayla Smith will come to the bench after just a few minutes. Soders will check back in. And sending shouts out to the Soders family. Don't see them in the stands. They're either on their way or waiting for Saturday. Well, they can just stay in Houston. Here we go. Jackson kicks it back right side. Back up top. Here we come around with Ariana Hunter. Now back to Breland. Breland takes it baseline. On the block. Throws it away. Here comes the Panthers. Hutchinson with the fast break in the open court. Hutchinson bringing it right side. Putting it off the glass. No. Soders to clean it up. Off the glass. Yeah. That's what we call running the floor. That cuts the lead to three. 16-13. The keys to the game, ladies and gentlemen, today. Danny Evans said, hey, we got to limit the turnovers. We got to continue to box out, beat them to the ball as they just did, and we got to average the same when we go down there. We need more than one shot. The second chance points here are what we need, and that's going to go against 32. Are we getting another foul against Lewis? Two in a row. Smith's going to have to come up off the bench. And Soders battling down there, and Lewis with a couple of fouls. Is that two on Lewis? Yeah. She'll have to take a seat, and Breland will take it out now for the Tigers of Jackson State. Hunter, left side to Bowler. Up off the bench, Jada Bowen. Cross court, right side now to Breland for three. On this. Payne gets it across the line, kicks it right side now to Williams. Williams trying to size up Jackson. Gives it to Smith. She'll be at the elbow. Smith now to Hutchinson. Down to 13 seconds on the shot clock. A lot of time. Hutch brings it left side. Steps back, thought about the three. Gives it up to Ryan Payne in the corner. Payne throws it up. Too high. And pushing and shoving under the bucket. Williams and Jackson battling. HR shoving stuff. Want to send shouts out to Corey Johnson. Crystal Edwards is headed to YouTube. Tilda Young, want to say hello to you. Reginald K. Miller, my brother, man, I'm praying for you, man. Hang in there, baby. We're going to be all right. Also, Dwayne Charleston's listening. My line brother, Vincent Huppauer. Want to send a shout out to y'all. Thanks for watching. Splendid Media Network and YouTube. If you want to see it. Down to 27 seconds left here on the first quarter. Down to 18 seconds. Hunter. We'll have it right side. Oh, Bowler gives it to her. That's an easy one right off the line. Bowler so long at that 6'1 guard slash forward. She can really do it. 21-13, a quick 8-point lead. But here comes Bowler, and here comes Payne to put it back in there and cut the lead to 6, ladies and gentlemen. Well, well, well. 15-21. The Tigers lead by 6. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. I hope... James is not listening and didn't catch me with the music in the background when we come back from break, JT. Don't just tell me at the last minute. JT Barton running the engineering for us today, ladies and gentlemen, and the cameras, and the graphics, and the sound. Mia's just over here looking fabulous, that's all. No, I'm just teasing. Mia's over here working real, real hard learning stats. Hey, folks, if you want to be a part of something wonderful, the Prairie View Department of Athletics needs you. We are looking for all former athletes to reach back out and engage with us. We had a wonderful time on, well, golly gee willikers, had a wonderful time on Saturday night with the 2013-2014 championship teams. They were honored with their 10-year anniversary. Jeanette Jackson, Shamaya Brooks, man, just the whole crew. I don't want to miss anybody's name. I shouldn't have called anybody. But I really enjoyed him, and we're starting a dynasty down here for women's basketball. Payne is asking for it. Bowen now with it, brings it left side down to 4 seconds. Somebody, we've got to shoot it. Hutchinson shoots it up. Oh, right at the buzzer, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. The Panthers missed an opportunity here. 9:28 left to play here in the second quarter. Man, the rebounding war. Little disparity here. 9-8, 1. The Panthers getting to the rebounds defensively and offensively as they throw it away. The Jackson State Tigers, that is. Jackson and Crump with a little miscommunication. Reed, Tamika, that is, kind of calm, cool, and collected. Bowen will now run the point for the Panthers. Payne will slide to the two for shooting. And Hutch is out there with Soders. All of the shooters for the Lady Panthers out there. Payne thought about it. Dribble drives. Kicks it over to Hutch. He thought about the dribble drive. Now takes it from 5. Has it blocked now from Jackson. Wow. And here comes Soders with some great defense. Good hustle. Oh, by Ryan Payne. But Soders with some just outstanding defense. Man, she could have played wide receiver for the Panthers the way she turned the Jets on that time. Here comes Roberson for the Lady Panthers, and a little help in a breather, man, with Hutchinson with some quality minutes for Prairie View and him. Sending shouts out to Indianapolis, Indiana, to the Roberson family. Thanks for watching exciting Panther sports. Soders steals it away. Good hand, Soders now kicks it over to Payne. 21-15, 6-point edge. The Panthers doing well here. Up top with it, Bowen is going to set up the offense. Smith setting it up last side. Run your sets here. That was another key. Smith from the right elbow. No good. Looks did 22 touch it, or they just let it go out of bounds? Over there on it was Mahoney. But it looked like it kind of touched Mahoney. Mahoney, nothing. Okay, the Tigers will retain possession. Hunter will bring it up. Hunter. Crump. Stolen away by Bowen. Here comes Bowen on the fast break with a double pump off the glass. Yeah, rolls in, baby. I love it. Man, she went up there with no fear. I like it. 7:57 left to play, 21-17, a four-point edge for the Tigers of Jackson State. The Panthers right there. Hunter up top working on Payne, brings it left side, tries to find the lane, cut off by Payne. They're going on the right side. Looking right, throws it right, gives it up now to Avant. Avant coming around with an elbow into the, come on, Avant, is that an offensive foul? They're going to call that with Jay the Bob and got her with her entire stomach, huh? Is that what it is? Golly gee. Bowen, here comes the play. Great angle. Look, now watch the crossover. Bowen staying with the defense, bumps her there. That's the first foul. The second foul is as she tries to go around near the elbow, she gets her with the shoulder. But that was the first foul. Man, gosh, man, this guy's great with the camera angles, folks. Here we go. Right side with it into Jackson. Jackson turns around. Oh, great defense by Bowen. Sticking it, playing the passing lanes, man. The Lady Panthers playing great. Hunter back up top. Is going to run the offense down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. She wants to challenge Payne. Payne with a great recovery. They give it over on the left side. Here comes Mahoney. Mahoney from 15. Off the glass, no. Knocked around, tipped around, snatched down by J. Robb. Here comes Robeson on the fast break. She has the numbers. Over the shoulder, off the blackboard. Yeah! Great play in transition. The Panthers have cut the lead to two. 21-19, 7 minutes left to play here in the second quarter. Man, you better call everybody. This is going to be a good one. Here comes Hunter on the left side. Hunter working on Crump in the middle. Gives it up now to Mahoney. Mahoney left side puts it up, and she's going to be hammered. But, man, what aggressive, good defense the Panthers are playing here. Now this is Lady Panther basketball. Look at this fast break. Great pass. Soders off the glass for two. I'm just so used to looking over my left shoulder to see the Soders family there. It's kind of strange. Somebody sitting in your seats. I'm going to have them removed here in just a moment. To the line are the Tigers of Jackson State. Is this the first trip to the charity stripe here? Checking the shot is away. It's good. The three-point play is good. Yeah, that was Jackson's first trip, JT, to the charity stripe all night. Does your mic work? JT Baird, ladies and gentlemen, just to give you a little background, is a graduate of Prairie View A&M University. Got his start over at KPTV. Is that right? Am I saying it right? I got your dossier down, right, because you're one of my kids. Came over to Panther Vision Sports, worked with the big dog his senior year. Only had him 1 year, folks, and now look at him. And I had to pull him back on the broadcast team. So proud of him. Here comes Roberson over the crossover, working that dribble. Takes it down low right there, waddle on it. Backboard for two! 24-21 after the three-point play. The Panthers just won't go away here. Here comes Hunter on the right side working on Payne. Hunter gives it up to Crump. Man, wow, she's wide open. Bowler, pardon me, and that's going to be a foul there. Golly gee, Williker's a ticky-tack foul. And, man, the Panthers are playing great. Sending shots out to my son, Lorenzo Porter. He's my biggest fan out there watching it at home with Barky and Burpee. How about that? 6:08 left to play here in the second quarter, folks. A fantastic game, 24-21 the score. The Panthers hanging in here with the league's leading team, the Jackson State Tigers, who are, folks, if you didn't know, well, now you do, 15-0, only lost six games this year. They're the big bully of the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Ashley Robinson has just done a great job with that program down at Jackson State, man, I tell you. And the shot is away. Oh, the I love. 6:08 left to play here. 26-21. Sending shots out to Charles Bishop. Hadn't had a chance to call my main man. I got to get a hold to him. Got some news for you, too, my good buddy. You're going to like it. Here we come left side now to Roberson. Roberson looking up for Smith. Smith looking in the corner trying to find Hutchman. Gets it over to Waddle. Waddle with the turnaround jumper off the backboard. Yeah, baby. Waddle doing her thing. Sending shouts out to the Waddle family. Okay, I'll just do it. Waddle, baby. Waddle, baby. Waddle. Here we go. Right side now. Hunter working now at the elbow. Loses the ball. Gets it back, though. Good defense by the Panthers. Crump has it on the left side. Crump looking down low. Jackson has it. Wants to work on Waddle. Turns, twists, puts it up with the right side. Yeah, Waddle with that clamp down defense. And they're going to call it towards the Jackson State side. Hit it back. Hit it on the out-of-bounds line. That's a better matchup with Waddle and Jackson up off the bench for the Jackson State Tigers. Luckett is going to come out and give Hunter a well-deserved breather. And I tell you, these Jackson State Tigers are fun to watch. Here come the Panthers, though. Crump puts it up from the free throw line. It's good for two. All right, here comes Payne. Brings it to the top of the key, 28-23, a five-point lead. Oh, missed opportunity turnover, unforced turnover. We can't have – that is, though, JT, the first unforced turnover of the game. The Panthers really playing some heads-up basketball in the Knicks Center tonight. Right side with it. Here comes Luckett. Luckett, man, just takes it coast-to-coast to the bucket. The rebound snatched down by Jackson. Finally corralled by Avon, and now the Jackson State Tigers will have a fresh shot clock. Here comes Luckett off the backboard. No, snatching down the rebound is Hickman. Hickman in the corner. Now they give it back up top to Luckett. Luckett down low. Gets it over on the right side to Jackson. She traveled. No call. Hits the front of the iron. And the Panthers with some good defense. We've got to stop it. Here comes Robeson off the glass with a double pump. And a foul. And Crump getting crunk down there with the Panthers. Jackson with a well-deserved rest is going to come down and sit up. Well, I'm sorry. I put that behind it. Yeah, there we go. The Panthers will have the ball. 4:31 left to play. 28-23. A five-point edge. The Panthers just lost an opportunity. We've got to get this one back. They're kicking back up top now over to Payne. And Roberson telling Payne, take it to the front court. Let's run the set. Payne looking up top. Right side with it is Smith. Smith looking down low trying to find Hutch. There's a mismatch. Michaela Hutchinson and Luckett down on the bottom. Now they – they quickly recover from that. Here comes J. Rob. Roberson, no. On the floor, jump ball, Jackson State. Up off the bench, Soders, man, we miss her production. And Phaedra Green is checking in for the Panthers. Green is the junior from Monroe, Louisiana. And in my opinion, I ain't the coach. Don't call coaches, say Porter trying to coach. But in my opinion, needs more time, man, because I tell you, she has been a firecracker for the Panthers here as of late, ladies and gentlemen. Media timeout on the court, ladies and gentlemen. Media timeout, 4:12 left to play in the first half, 28-23. The Panthers down by five. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Yeah, Spider-Man and Freeze in full effect.
Basketball tournament presented by Buick returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 4:12 left to play. The Panthers are down by five. The best stat passer-outer in America, Kikondria. I can't remember Kiki's last name. We got a great group here, ladies and gentlemen. It's our final home game. And we sincerely thank all of our volunteers, all of our student workers, all of our workers that come in and make this really, really special. This has just been an outstanding year, the game day experience here on the campus of Prairie View A&M is so much different, man. Here's what I'm really, really interested in is the rebounding and the points in the paint. The Jackson State Tigers, three better rebounds than the Panthers, 13-10. Crump brings it left side on Phaedra Green. Green comes right in with a block, ladies and gentlemen, told you. And here we come left side, oh, man, with an easy lane to the bucket. And Hutch blocks it on the left side, gets a piece of finger on that one. That's a good. Now here we go. Check it out, folks. Here's the here's Luckett coming in the point. Now Hutchinson just got her on the finger, man. Golly gee. Wow. 3:51 left to play. 28-23 at the line to shoot free throws. Luckett. The Tigers come in shooting 69% from the charity stripe. They average about 16 free throws a game. They're getting there a lot. And Luckett, not a slouch herself, 79% from the charity stripe, pretty much 79.5. What do you say, 80% from the free throw line? She's doing well. Okay, 7-point edge here, 30-23. Hutchinson back up top to Waddle. Green wants it. They throw it out now to Payne. She has to chase it down around Luckett. Here comes Waddle asking for it now. Waddle down low trying to work there on Hickman. Or pardon me, Walker. That's Walker number 5. Here we go. Payne from 20. It's good. Layla Walker snuck in on us, folks. Sophomore from Gulfport, Mississippi. Pardon me. Here we go. Left side with it. Bowler has it blocked. Soders and Waddle get in there. And here comes Smith. And Smith is going to give Freda Green a break. Green with some quality minutes over there. Some good defense from Phaedra Green, the junior from Monroe, Louisiana. She'll be back next year. Got to keep the nucleus of this team together. Smith with the rebound, gives it back out now to Payne, and Payne will bring it to the forecourt left side. 3 minutes left to play here in the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers down by 5. And if you've been following, you know how rough it was for the Panthers down in Jackson, man. They are really doing a great job of showing what they can really do here in Pantherland. Here comes Hutchinson, kicks it left side. Over now to Payne. She facing in the corner to Smith now. Has to reverse it with a right hand to the left hand and can't find the hole. Mia Crump, the Jax Yates product, has it in the open court. Oh, man, wide open. Bowler can't miss that one. Nobody got over there on that left block. Everybody shifted right. Got to keep our head in the game here. 7-point lead now, 32-25. We've lost two shots, two opportunities that will keep us within 3. Here comes Soders. Soders, we need that three-pointer. Where you at? Here comes Hutchinson. Hutchinson working on Bowler. Brings it back right side. Thought about the skip step. Steps back. Shoots it from 20. Hits the side of the iron. Chased down by the Tigers. Oh, man, we've got it. Oh, and Luckett. It dribbles off of Luckett's foot. And here comes Jackson State. Crump. A little winded. She's going to get a break. Avant will come in along with Jackson. Bowler will stay out for the Tigers along with Hickman. J. Rob will come in along with Phaedra Green for the Panthers. And I really like Green, folks. Green, Waddle, and Williams, the nucleus of this team, folks, are what we're going to build our future from. Back to the issue at hand. Left side with it. Smith has it on the elbow, left side. Looking down low, Green wanted to give it up to Soder. She thought about it, now puts it up from 15. It's the front of the iron, no. Smith with some good hands, puts it back up, turnaround jumper, no. Soders tries to snatch it away. Soders with the tie-up, they're going to call. Oh, they call Soders with a foul. No, golly gee. They're both going for the ball, ref. Here we go, running back, JT. Right side with it now. Here's Smith's shot from 15, puts it up. Green can't snatch it. Soders gets it, but gets some arm trying to corral the ball. The Panthers now with 5 team fouls, and will take the long walk down. And Bowler now will be shooting free throws. Tylon Bowler. Wait a minute. Tyon Bowler. Pardon me, Jackson State folks. Tyon Bowler, a 71% shooter for the Jackson State Tigers. That's a hyphen. Not a 9. Second shot is away. It's good. 34-29. Now a 9-point lead. The Panthers with 4 missed shots, 4 opportunities down here. That would have kept them right behind the Jackson State Tigers. We've got to do better. Green kicks it back up now to Payne. Somebody else has got to take the load off of Payne. Payne jumps back, gives it over to J-Rob. Rob in the corner, wide open. Smith, we need it. Too far, but Phaedra Green, oh, right back under there with it. And Jackson coming in mauling Jada Roberson. That'll be her second personal. Is that her first? Second personal? What's going on here? 15. Where's the fouls? Second personal what? Where's the foul? Somebody's a little slow here. Let's get the so first. Her first personal. And that's what they're looking at. See, that's just not me. The Jackson State Tigers are trying to say, hey, what's going on? The numbers are not up there on the Jumbotron. Kind of easier to see, folks. If you need to look at the live stats, which I should be looking at, I'm going to have to look up there, folks. Just go to www.pvpanthers.com. Stop laughing, JT. Go to www.pvpanthers.com. pvpanthers.com. Go down about midways. You'll see the game there in our schedule. There's a hamburger drop-down box there on the right side. Click that. You can get the live stats. It'll also push you right straight to Panther Vision here. Under a minute left to play, 34-26. J-Rob with a great steal. Green can't hold on to it. Soders gets it. Green keeping it alive. Bowen gets it now, and here come the Panthers for the last shot. Bowen coming down right side and a foul. Good job. Avant trying to come over and break her out. Avant kind of all over Roberson. And Avant not a real, real happy camper. And the Panthers will have it. Want to send a shout out to one of the big bosses, James Crenshaw, Woodlawn Entertainment, somewhere in the back of Jackson, Mississippi. Here we go, left side now, Roberson with it. Roberson into the hands of Jada Bowen, down to 14 seconds on the shot clock, about a 14-second differential between the game and shot clock. Here comes Bowen, now back out to Smith. Great job, Smith. Cans it, baby. That's what I'm talking about. The lead six now for the Jackson State Tigers. 10 seconds left to play. Right side with it. Here comes Breland. See, travel, no call. Boulder now brings it right side. Just throws it up. No. Hits the front of the iron. No good. Here comes a Bowen. Just throw it up. No good. It's going to be too late. Golly gee, Willikers. What an exciting first half, ladies and gentlemen, here in the William Nix Center. The Panthers hanging in here with the Southwestern Athletic Conference leader, the Jackson State Tigers. Man, this is a heck of a game. It's worth the price of the ticket, ladies and gentlemen. You got to come back for more. Stick around. We'll go to our studios for halftime and then come back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M Panther Sports Network.
The 2024 Starry Sweat Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top 8 teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
Just don't set it off.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
So, Coach.
What made you go?
Hey, I was checking out this 2024 home schedule. Looking good, man. This is definitely get fans in the stands.
Absolutely. We need fans in the stands, right? To come support our 23 Western Division champions. All right, here. This one we're going to start it right here. August 31st, we got Texas Southern. You guys know that's going to be a huge game, big-time game. We need everybody out there. Then we jump down to September 21st against Southern. Big rival game. We play them at home. We got them last year. We'll get them again this year. Then we jump down to October 9th. We got a bye. Then we come to October 26th. We got Texas Commerce for homecoming. We know how we do it at homecoming. We need you out there. Go back down. We jump down to November 9th. We got Florida A&M. Played them twice last year. All right. Now we got them first this year. Then we go to November 16th. We finish up with Alcorn.
That's a heck of a season. You know, for me, I got to tell you what time it is.
What time is it?
It's time for PV Nation to buy their home season tickets right now, today. Go to pvpanthers.com and buy your season tickets today.
Go Panthers!
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaul. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Thank you.
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
So, Coach.
What's up, Eagle?
Hey, I was checking out this 2024 home schedule. Looking good, man. This is definitely get fans in the stands.
Absolutely. We need fans in the stands, right? To come support our 23 Western Division champions. All right, here. This one we're going to start it right here. August 31st, we got Texas Southern. You guys know that's going to be a huge game, big-time game. We need everybody out there. Then we jump down to September 21st against Southern. Big rival game. We play them at home. We got them last year. We'll get them again this year. Then we jump down to October 9th. We got a bye. Then we come to October 26th. We got Texas Commerce for homecoming. We know how we do at homecoming. We need you out there. Go back down. We jump down to November 9th. We got Florida A&M. Played them twice last year. All right. Now we got them first this year. Then we go to November 16th. We finish up with Alcorn.
That's a heck of a season. You know, for me, I got to tell you what time it is.
What time is it?
It's time for PV Nation to buy their home season tickets right now, today. Go to PVPanthers.com and buy your season tickets today.
Go Panthers!
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool your school. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
The 2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
The William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Halftime score 34-28. The Panthers down by six, man. Really, really keeping it close here for the this final contest, this final home game. The Panthers, man, really, if they can keep this up, I think they can play with them, and maybe we can get our AD over here to chat with us a bit. I know there's got some information that we're going to be disseminating to you as far as season tickets, as far as all kinds of things are concerned. We've got some new initiatives, and we've got a new AD who was supposed to come on with us. Is that okay? I'm sorry. You got something else? Go ahead. You can come back. You know, I missed my AD who is going to be I'm going to be his wingman. How about that? How's it going?
Good, brother.
I tell you, I must compliment you on your new attire.
Come on now.
You have really laid right in here with us. You came in, got to Texas. I remember, man, when you just had the tennis shoes on and the sports coat. But now you have discovered cowboy hats. You're going to need it in the summer, man. What about the Lady Panthers and the way they're playing here today? Keeping it very, very close. We had some keys to the game, AD, and those keys were the turnovers, boxing out, beating Jackson State to the ball. And if we look at the statistics, the Panthers are just doing that. In the paint, we're knotted at 16. They're two better than us in the rebounding categories. But look at our turnovers. Four turnovers for the Panthers, seven turnovers for the Tigers of Jackson State. We're beating them by six, with the points off of turnovers and our second chance points. We're tied.
I like our fight. I like what we're doing as far as our energy and what we're trying to hang in there. We've got to make our layups. We've missed a lot of layups, and so that's the difference between 6 points right there.
Well, in the second quarter, the Panthers went cold. Looking at the statistics, folks, the Panthers in the second half went 6 for 15, while the Tigers were 12 of 29. We missed four opportunities down there, four open shots that would have kept us right in it.
Yeah,
34-28 to score, a six-point edge. Want to send a shout to an undisclosed place somewhere where it's very cold, to Wendy Marvin and the Super Friends. How about that? I couldn't wait to get you on to say that.
No doubt.
9-14 left to play. Angel Jackson playing well. The Tigers didn't like the call. And that was – no, the Panthers don't like the call, because that is – against Williams. That should be her second personal. That's going to see Hutchinson come in and Waddle. Man, Waddle's been playing great off the bench. She's long, very, very athletic, man. And you've got to shoot over her because she has some extremely long arms.
She does.
Here we go, left side with it. Here comes Crump on the baseline. Crump looking down low, gives it up on the right side to Mahoney. Oh. Mahoney finds a hole, with double pump, puts it off the glass.
Oh, I don't know about that one.
Got her with the body. And you know, man, I just got to thank you for all of these extras that you sent. But if you look at the replay, here's Mahoney and Smith got her with the body. See, you paid
it's
for that.
Call.
That instant replay stuff, you paid a little extra money for that. That's what we got.
I tried to do a little something for you.
Hey, man. It's great, and I just want to inform you, we're leading the conference in views. I've talked with Andrew down at the Southwestern Athletic Conference, and they're very, very interested in what we're doing because we're leading in views, and it's because you started coming on. That's why. 9:05 left to play. Here comes the free throw. It's away. It's good now. 36-28. The Panthers missed another opportunity.
We need a bucket here.
In the early going, absolutely. Payne trying to fight a way out of the trap. Gets it over now to Soders, and Soders – we'll slow it down. We'll run the set.
And see, they're trying to get the ball out of Payne's hands.
Absolutely. Payne with a turnaround jumper. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Here comes that long Waddle, and Waddle will fight for it, and that's why it's out of bounds.
Panthers ball.
On Jackson. Absolutely. We're going to have somebody that's going to step up and score. Where's Soders and where's Smith? We need the Michaela Hutchinson. That was also a score. And a couple of games ago, Kayla Smith hit 20 points. Against Mississippi Valley State, so she's waiting to have another breakout game.
Have we hit any threes?
No.
Our
three-point range is we're really doing poorly from three-point range. We are 1 of 5 from the arc, and we've got to do better with that. We would get them from beating us in the paint. They'll have to come out and be honest and guard us on the perimeter.
Because how many have they scored? I know they've hit at least three, right?
Well, they are 7 of 7. Pardon me, 3 of 6.
Yeah, I knew they
from
had three.
The three-point range. Here we go down to 4 seconds. Payne's got to do something with it. Puts it up. Hits the side of the iron. It's short, and we're going back the other way. 8:22 left to play here. Right side
tough
with
shot.
It is Mia Crump, the Jack Yates product. She hits the side of the iron. No good. Payne will pull it down. Payne on the fast break. Slows it up. Runs the set. Right side with it now to Smith. Smith back up top to Hutchinson. Soder standing in the corner. Wants it. Hutchinson coming around. Here comes Soders with it. Down to 16 seconds on the shot clock. Soders coming left, looking for Waddle.
Somebody's got to get down low.
Yeah, Waddle's got to bail her out. Somebody's got to get on the blocks. Here comes Payne. Oh, great pass to Soders from 10. Ah, back of the iron, too much. Waddle gets it, and she's fouled by Jackson.
Go.
That's three.
Somebody's got to get down low. We have to have a presence down low if we want to compete in this game.
Keys to the game, folks. We talked about it. Boxing out and rebounding that time. A good job of Waddle staying with the play and coming to get the rebound and keeping it on the Panthers in. 7:48 left to play here in the third. The Panthers are down by 8.
These are important free throws right here.
Checking in for the Panthers, Jada Robeson, the outstanding player from Indianapolis, Indiana. The Panthers in the first half from the charity stripe. Only
those are first points?
That's our first points of this quarter.
Right.
Yes, it is.
Let's go.
We were 3 from 4 from the free throw line. To shoot 75% in the first half. That one is away. It's good. The second one is away. This good. We had an opportunity last week, AD, to have a meeting with our fundraising groups. Got a lot of things coming up. The Prairie View Relays are coming up on the 27th. We've
excited
also
about
got
that.
April 12th is the spring football game. Man, this spring football game, folks, you got to come out here, man.
Yeah.
They have planned some stuff, including the Panther Plaza, and just a lot of things that's going to be really, really fun. A lot of ways for you to support Prairie View A&M are opening right now. The door is wide open. Here comes Roberson. She'll stand at the top of the key. Bring it left side, finds a lane. Here comes Robeson with the double pump. She's going to be fouled.
That's a good – that she went straight to the hole with that. Like, that's what we got to do. If they're going to be super aggressive and try to block everything, you got to go to the hole and make them pay for that.
Here comes – that's going to go against Layla Walker, man. I tell you, I have not seen Sandy Pugh like a Bengal tiger, like kind of like the people across going back and forth down the –
She's getting in tournament mode. She's getting in tournament mode. I like it.
13th through the 16th down at Bartow Arena in Birmingham, Alabama. Would love to go, but I think we got softball. I think I'll have to stay home this time. 7:24 left to play. Now a 5-point lead. The Panthers eating back into this lead, which was as many as eight by the Tigers of Jackson State. Second one is way and off the leg of Mahoney.
Another chance.
And the Panthers will have it. Mahoney's not happy with it. And Reed, she's the new Freda Freeman Jackson.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, she's intense.
That was definitely off them, though.
Definitely off her foot.
You can't argue that one.
Roberson gets it in, 20 on the shot clock. Roberson will bring it out to run the set. Smith will stay along the wing. Walker trying to put some clamps on Smith. Lewis needs to get involved here. Here comes Payne now on the left wing, coming around, trying to bring it to the right four side. Brings it right in the elbow, on the corner, baseline. Lewis with a double pump. She's fouled as time expires.
Here I thought they might have called a foul on that one.
I did too. Hunter, left side. Payne almost got it in the crump. Great pass down low, man. That's just good basketball right there by the Jackson State Tigers. Luckett with the point now. 6:48 now the lead back to 7. We are still in it.
Yeah, we gambled on that one. They made us pay.
Absolutely. Here comes Payne. Left side now to Smith. Smith taking it on the baseline. The dribble drive, a double pump to the left hand off the glass. Here comes Robinson with the cleanup. Yeah! It's good for 2.
There it is. You got to get on the glass. Got to get on the glass. That was a foul, though. That was definitely a foul.
That was an and one. I wish we had time for the replay. They missed the shot. There it is right there. And one.
That is a foul.
And timeout called here by the Tigers of Jackson State coach. I mean, pardon me, AD, I don't know how long you can hang out, but we appreciate you coming to hang out. Let's talk quickly about some of the fundraising efforts that you had. You've got a great video out there.
Yeah.
What are we going to do?
I
like that video. I really like it. I mean, Ms. Thurston is coming up with so many creative ways to market and brand this program. I'm so proud of her. Got in trouble last week because sometimes I get a little overzealous. But I tell you, I'm just so excited because we have not had this kind of energy, this kind of support in a long time. And it's quite refreshing.
I mean, it's definitely a group effort. You know, what we're trying to do is continue to upgrade our facilities, add money for our student-athletes to get scholarships, look at nutrition. Like, I'm trying to do the whole gamut. And so if anybody's interested, all they need to do is go to pvpanthers.com, click the give button, and you can give to the general fund, and I can do something with your money, or you can give to a specific sport.
We are putting together an initiative to go out and grab some corporate sponsorship packages. I've got a special surprise for you Wednesday.
Okay.
This Wednesday at the softball game, one of a major player in this community is coming to the softball game, wants to meet you.
I've
been sending that to you. But that is a testament of the type of excitement and the type of attention you're garnering here. More and more people. I know everybody. So now people that we begged and I called years ago now are calling me to get in touch with you.
Yeah.
So it's been a great experience, man. And we're behind you 1,000%.
Appreciate it. Want me to get out of here and let you do
Thank
your
you
thing,
so much.
Man.
And
Thank
please,
you,
please save me from Ms. Thurston because this was an impromptu interview and I got the soul sister looking finger.
It's all good, man. Anytime. Take care, brother.
Thank you, sir. Anton Goff, the athletic director here at Prairie View A&M University, who is doing a fine job and looking pretty darn spiffy in his Texan gear. 6:09 left to play here in the William Nix Center. My liege here, Mia Greer, working hard and making the big dog look good, Crystal. Payne has it at the top of the key. 6:53 left to play. It's only a 5-point edge, folks. The Panthers lost by 20. Well, more than 20 down to Jackson State. Here we go with the turnaround. Oh, and Lewis is going to be called with the spin and roll. And the fans and Soders and Porter and Barrett and the police don't like it. 5:45 left to play in the third quarter. A 5-point edge, 38-33. Another opportunity there. That's number 5. Here comes Luckett. Is that Luckett? Pardon me. Yeah, Luckett on the right side. Luckett looking down low. Can't find Walker. And it's knocked away by Payne from Crump. Luckett has it now. Wants to work on Payne. Brings it right side. Good defense. They throw it up. Roberson in the land of the Giants picks it up. Here comes Roberson on the fast break with the numbers. Roberson stops, pops, puts it up, hits the front of the iron. No, didn't wait for some help. Another blown opportunity, but the Panthers with the defense. Sauters with the steal. And two from Roberson. Pardon me, that's Lewis. Lewis with the steal. She's the artful dodger. She's doing a great job there. Picking the pocket. She's a pocket picker. And she picks the pocket again. Lewis and Roberson doing great on defense. Here comes Payne. Payne slows it down, 35-38. The Panthers down by three. Payne brings it to the forecourt. Shoots it left side. Smith finds it. That's her shot off the glass for two. The Panthers are down by one, 38-37. Here in the William Nix Center in the third quarter, where the Panther fans get off your feet. And Luckett brings it over the Panthers all over now. The Jackson State Tigers 38-37. Man, this is a barn burner. Stick around, we'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
2024 Starry Swag Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament presented by Buick returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top eight teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
And JT Barrett bringing you live coverage from courtside. The Panthers, man, are playing pretty much the best game of the year here in the Baby Dome, holding the Jackson State Tigers down to 38 points, 38-37 with 4:15 left. Oh, I'm in trouble. Okay. I'm going to blame it on JT this time. He said, music. Uh-oh, your phone's going off? Is that the boss? Okay, I'm sorry, James. James Crenshaw milling around somewhere by the Country Fisherman. Is the Country Fisherman still going on down there? We got to go to Jackson State and go to the Country Fisherman. Here we go, left side. Luckett will get it. Man, Crump now on the baseline with a great move. Puts it up. She's going to be fouled. They're going to call that one on Waddle. And Coach Danny Evans signaling to Waddle to put your hands straight up. You were kind of leaning over and got her on the shoulder. Don't get exciting men's action coming your way. The Jackson State Tigers in town. The Panthers, their final home game. Folks, just got the news. We will be going down to Texas Southern to bring you coverage. Not video coverage, but audio coverage on our YouTube page. So you can hear what's going on our YouTube page. We're going to put a graphic up, and you'll be able to hear the audio this Friday. We're going to try to get permission from Texas Southern to do our splendid thing. Here comes Kayla Smith over to Waddle. Waddle couldn't hold on to it. Has to give it up now to Roberson. She's on the baseline. Roberson looking right side, and we'll have to bring it back out. Pass a little hard for Waddle. She was wide open under the bucket. Three-point edge, 40-37. Smith has it left side. Walker comes out to get her. Smith finds it, kicks it right side. Here comes Payne for three. Oh! Payne with a huge shot, ladies and gentlemen, to tie it at 40 with 3:26 left to play here in the third quarter. The Panthers are playing great. Luckett with it now over to Crump. Crump looking right side. Bowler wants it. She gets it on the wing. Bowler looking down low. Now they get it to Jackson. Great pass over the man to Bowler. Golly gee, Willikers. That's Globetrotterish, man. That was just beautiful. Textbook. These ladies have really been working hard, but the Panthers are on them. Boy, like some skin. Here comes Roberson looking on the left side. Wide open. Smith for three. Come on. Oh! Kayla Smith for three. to tie it up on the Panthers by one. Yeah, the Panthers take their first lead of the game, 43-42. Left side with it was Hickman, and Hickman gets it right side. Here's another shot to put the Tigers up by two on that three-point shot, 45-43. Payne, Smith left side. Smith brings it to the top of the key, puts it up. No good. Waddle can't get it. And Crump comes down left side. Bowler for three. Ooh-wee. No, hits the side of the iron. Roberson with another huge rebound. And here come the Panthers. There's Waddle. Smith over on the corner for three. Looks good. Oh, man, the Panthers will have loved it. Payne with the rebound. She puts it up for two. We're tied again. 45-45. The Panthers hanging in here, baby. 1:54 left to play in the third. You better call some folks. It's hot in here. 1:45 left to play. Here comes Luckin on the right side, finds a lane, and Waddle got her on the arm, but that stops the momentum. But man, what an exhilarating third half or third quarter, folks. Pardon me, the Panthers, man, really playing well with the league's leader, the Jackson State Tigers, coming into the Baby Dome tonight, 15-0, and they're having that perfect record threatened. What a way to go to TSU and then to the tournament, if we can pull this one off, folks. Luckett at the line shooting two. Shots away, it's good. They're pretty good, folks. 69% from the charity stripe. The Panthers at 72%. Or do I have it backwards? No, I'm correct. The Panthers actually at 70% from the charity stripe. The Jackson State Tigers at 68% from the charity stripe. Or actually 69. So they're neck and neck from the charity stripe. 1:24 left to play. The Panthers have it knocked away. Waddle gets it. 9 seconds left. J. Rob's got to take it to the bucket. Puts it up. That's her shot. No. And it's out of bounds on Jackson. She's standing out of bounds. It hits her on the leg. 4 seconds left to play, enough for a catch. Kind of slightly think about it and shoot. Roberson in to Payne from five. Yeah, and one. Payne hits the shot and is fouled. The Panthers tie it up at 47 with a chance to take the lead, with the and one free throw by Ryan Payne. The Panthers getting back on defense. Payne with an opportunity for one shot. Payne will be shooting one, checking in for the Tigers. Zakiya Mahoney, the graduate student from Oakland, California. Oakland, Los Angeles. Very near, I think it's what? Right up 181 from Los Angeles to, Oakland's near San Francisco. I'm thinking about Long Beach, folks. Let me get it right. Here we go, left side, Luckett. Up top, Mahoney wants to work, turns, twists in the paint, and picks up some Samsonite and Birkin. She's traveling, and we're going back the other way. Reed wasn't too particular on the call there. Up top now, Payne has it right side to Roberson. The Panthers' quickest guards are in. Under a minute left to play. The Panthers up by 148-47. Here comes Smith, shoots it down low, gets it to Roberson. For two! J-Rob with two. 50-47, the Panthers with their largest lead of the game at three. 50-47, the Tigers are rattled. And Payne is going to be called for the ticky-tack foul. I didn't even really see the play, but I'm just calling it ticky-tack. We'll run it back. JT Barrett on it. We'll see as they no, too late? Too late. Okay, golly gee willikers. Stop looking at Facebook. No, I'm just teasing. Luckett at the line for free throws. One of two on her last trip, or was it two of two? Let's see. And here's Luckett at the free throw line. The shot is away. It's good. Both shots good here. 50-49 with 28 seconds left to play here in the third. The Panthers are still up by one. Here comes Payne. Payne looking left side. She's going to play for the last shot. And not a very happy look on the face of the Jackson State Lady Tigers. Payne coming left side. Finds an opening. Kicks it back out to Smith for three. Off the mark. Oh, my goodness. Got the play that we wanted. The shot just didn't fall, ladies and gentlemen, and the Panthers here are really pushing it well. They're pushing it up the court, folks, and they're trying to keep it going, ladies and gentlemen. 10 more minutes left. 10 minutes left in this one. The Panthers are up by one, 50-49. We'll be right back.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 10 minutes left to play here in this one. The Panthers are on top of Jackson State by 1 point, 50-49. What I was interested in is this, and it's working. The points in the paint and the second chance points are what's keeping Prairie View in this game. 26 points in the paint for the Panthers, 18 for Jackson State. The second chance points and the rebounds where the disparity is. 5 second chance points for Jackson State, 16 for the Panthers. 21 rebounds for Jackson State. The Panthers have bettered the Tigers here in the third quarter with rebounds and out-rebounded them by 4, 25-21. Man. Ryan Payne leading all scorers with 16 points. Right behind her is Tion Bowler with another three-pointer. And now Tion Bowler leading all scorers. That's 17 points for her. 50-52, the Panthers going up for it, and it's going to be a foul called. Are they going to call that one on two? Is that Crump? No, 10. They're going to call that one on Luckett. That's going to be three on Luckett. Two fouls on Luckett. Jackson is with the one with the three fouls for the Tigers. Folks, want to remind you, exciting Panthers softball. I guess we're going to have to find another adjective than exciting, but great home run hitting, base stealing. Lady Panthers softball is coming your way this Wednesday at 2 o'clock right here from the Lady Panthers softball field as the Lady Panthers take on the Penn Quakers from Pennsylvania. 1740 when they were founded. They're doing a little homework last night. The Penn Quakers, Pennsylvania Quakers, coming to town. 9:39 left to play. The shot is away. Payne is good. And, man, this has been an exciting. I think we'll probably get a post-game interview after this, you think? Second shot is away. It's good. Luckett to run the point. Got stuck. Jackson now has to come and give her a little help. Here we come back right side. And they're going to call that one on Smith with the push. And Kayla Smith with the foul on the floor. One foul apiece for each team. Want to send a shout out to Dallas, Texas. Man, we're so happy to see Granny and LaToya. LaCondria's mom and grandmother and her brother and whole family came down the other day. Wanted to send a shout out to her as Crump shoots it up for three. No. Waddle comes down with a big rebound. Gets it out now to Payne. The Panthers tied at 52 with the Tigers. Here comes Payne. Payne looking up top. Gives it now to Roberson. She brings it to the right side. Look, oh, great pass to Smith. Smith puts it up from five. No. Rush the shot. One missed opportunity here in the fourth quarter. Crump working, crossing over, gives it up. Now to Bowler. Bowler looking to Luckett. Luckett coming right side, finds a lane, finds a hole. It's knocked away by Roberson. Here comes Roberson in the open court. Roberson going left, stops, going to slow it up. Gives it into the corner. Now to Payne. Payne thought about the three-pointer. Steps inside, now steps back. Beyond the arc is going to set up the sit for Coach. 8:17 left to play. 16 seconds on the shot clock. Here we go. Waddle comes right side, left side with it now. Smith wants to work on Luckett. That's a mismatch. Right side now. Payne wide open for three. Booyah! Payne is on fire. 55-52. The Panthers go back up by three for the third time in the contest. Luckett right side, Crump for three. That looks good, yeah. The answer. And it's getting a little chippy out there, Charles Bishop. A little chippy. And I'm not talking about chocolate chips. Want to send a shout out to Gil Rodriguez and Chili Davis. They're watching Jay Proctor. Hey, Lori. And my frat brother, Silas McMorris, all checking us out on the Splendid Media Network. Here comes Geraldine Smith. The rebound chased out, oh, by Waddle and Smith with some body. Now they're starting to call some ticky-tack fouls for the fourth quarter. Let them play. They've been playing the little hip fouls. Come on. Let's not start that here. And, yeah, I hope, but don't want to have an outburst. Shame on me. Huh? 7:19 left to play. Luckett brings it right side, working with Jackson, goes around Smith, cut off, and it's out of bounds. The Panthers get it. Great defense that time by Smith and Williams on the baseline, cutting off the offensive player. Great, great defense. Here comes Michaela Hutchinson, J-Rob. We'll check in with some quality minutes, man, some real quality minutes from Jada Roberson, the graduate student from Indiana. Payne will have it now. 55-55, 6:55 left to play. Wow, got it. Payne, right side, Smith. Down to 14 seconds on the shot clock. Still have time to work. Hutchinson gets it. Oh, my. Wow, unforced turnover. That's right. Payne is going to keep everybody fine. It's 55-55. The Panthers now, golly gee, gave that one away. Here come the Tigers. Oh, man. A push off from Crump. And Crump pushed out on the shot. And we're going down the other way. Reed didn't like it. Here comes the play, watch. Right side, Crump pushes off with the right arm. She led with the right arm and pushed off. That's a good call by the official. And the Panthers now will have it with 6 minutes, 30 seconds left to play, 55-55 to score. Payne from the right elbow. Hits the back of the iron, no good. Jackson with the rebound. Here come the Tigers. Hunter comes left side. Bowler wants it, but they keep it with Hunter. She'll bring it back right, trying to find Mahoney down low. That's a double pump. And in the bucket, there goes Maya Crump. Mahoney on the baseline working on Michaela Hutchinson. Payne wants to work on Luckett, drops it down on the elbow to Smith. Smith working on Crump, brings it to the center. Oh, throws it down with a bad pass. Smith or Williams bailed out on that one. Pushed in the back by Jackson. Is that, let's see. Jackson, I think, pushed Williams in the back. Is that the call? And, yeah, Jackson's going to come out of the game. And the Panthers will have it with 20. 5:40 left to play, folks. The Tigers up by two, 55-57. We need a score here. Match buckets all the way down the stretch here. Roberson comes left side, finds it, double pumps it. It's no good. Gets her own rebound, turns around, puts it back up, falls off the right side. And the Tigers have it. Mahoney chases it down and gives it over to Bowler. And Hunter now will walk it up for Jackson State. Bowler's wide open. You can't leave her open like that. She hits the side of the iron, no good. Crump with the putback. Walker with it to Bowler. Back over to Crump. She'll set it back up. The Panthers with good defense that time, just didn't get the rebound. Luckett to Hunter. Hunter can't find the hole. It's chased down, goes out of bounds. The Panthers will have the ball. Here comes Kayla Smith, who has had some huge buckets here down the stretch for Coach Sandy Pugh. Okay, folks, here's the scenario. 4:56 left to play. The Panthers up by two, down by two, pardon me. Panthers down by two, 57-55. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Next center, ladies and gentlemen, Charles Porter, JT Barrett, and Mia Greer. The Panthers are down by two, 57-55, man. What an incredible game. The Panthers, man, with great clamp-down defense, outscoring the Tigers in the paint and in second-chance points, also out-rebounding them. They kind of picked it up. They're out-rebounding them by one now, 25-26. The Panthers here, 4 of 10 from the three-point range here for the game. In the fourth quarter, 1 of 1, and only 1 of 5 field goals so far to shoot 20% here in the fourth. Williams thought about the three-pointer, faked the three-pointer. Everybody stood up and said, no! Lewis will have it. Now back over to Payne. Williams can hit the three-pointer, by the way. Here we go now with Roberson. She's thinking about it, trying to find a hole. Steps back, kicks it over right side now. Soders puts it up. Lewis for two! Desiree Lewis with a big shot for the Panthers, all the way from Converse, Texas, baby. Tied at 57 with 4:24 left to play in this one. Hunter brings it right side, looks back up top now, gives it over to Bowler. Bowler from the left elbow has it partially blocked. Oh, man. Was that a James Harden? We got to look at that one. Okay, here we come. Here comes Luckett with it. Now to Hunter. Oh, we missed it. Okay, we got to go back. Oh, my golly gee, well, I'm gonna scream there, JT, man. We're about to break that one down. Tamika Reed looking calm, cool, and collected on the line for Jackson State. Bowler uncharacteristically misses the shot. Three team fouls for the Panthers, three team fouls for the Tigers. Should be interesting down the stretch. 57-51. The second shot from Teon Bowler is away and good. Walker is going to come and take a seat. They're going to put Jackson back in here. Folks, don't forget exciting men's action coming your way. The season finale of exciting Panther basketball right here in the William Nix Center. One more game. Let's break the bank. Let's call everybody we know. We're trying to get 5,000 views tonight. Lewis back up top now to Payne. Payne working hard. Comes left side. Hunter back on her. Hunter coming right side, and the Panthers lose another opportunity. Golly gee. 58-57. The Panthers with now only 8 turnovers. Only 3 of those were unforced. 13 turnovers by the Tigers. Jackson at the top of the key gives it back up to Hunter. Hunter works right side on Ryan Payne. She goes around the pick set by Jackson, then puts it up no good. Oh, Williams misses that rebound and is fouled, and Williams has got to grab that. Williams has got to grab that one. Come on. Somebody's got to pull them together and say, hey, keep your head. Waddle's going to come out. Jackson Williams needs a breather. She needs a blow. We'll get Waddle back in there for some offense. 58-57, only a one-point edge in this one, folks. Here comes Jalen Smith up off the bench for more offense. Shot is away. It's good. Now the Tigers by a deuce, 59-57. Shot is away, and it's good. And here come the Panthers. Pretty good free throw shooter is Jackson. Angel Jackson, 83%. Came in tonight 65 of 78 for the year. Looking pretty darn good. 3:30 left to play. Here come the Panthers. Roberson to Waddle in the corner. Now to Payne. Payne doubled and out to Smith for two. Payne doubled in the corner there. They kick it out to Smith at the free throw for 2 points. The Panthers down by 160-59. Down to 3 minutes to play. Hunter puts it up off the backboard, and they're going to call J. Rob with that one. And Roberson with the body. And Hunter, slow to get up. Or no, that's Luckett. Is that 10? 10. That's 10 slow to get up. Pardon me, folks. Folks standing all in the way. 2:59 left to play. On 1 point edge by the Tigers of Jackson State here. The Panthers trying to play spoiler for their season. And hand them a loss to come in 15-0. Shot is away. It's good. 2 point edge now, 61-59. The score. What did I do? Barrett or Barnett? What do you mean messing your name up? I know your name is Barrett. How many, what did I say, Barnett one time? Okay, sue me. Here we go, left side. Oh, that was your mom? Oh, I'm sorry. Smith with a double pump off the glass for two. Yeah, baby. 62-61. Folks, 2:37 left to play. We're getting close to crunch time. Payne, good cutoff that time. And then they called timeout. Tamika Reed did. And you should have saw the look on Waddle's face. He thought Waddle had been called for the foul. And, man, that would have been really bad for the Panthers. Stick around. 2:30 left to play. The Panthers are right here in it, folks. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Bird View A&M University. Panther Sports Network.
The 2024 Starry Sweat Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament, presented by Buick, returns to the Magic City on Wednesday, March 13th through Saturday, March 16th. As the league's top 8 teams on both sides look to bring home championship titles with two NCAA tournament berths on the line. This year's tournament is selected to be held at Bartow Arena, with all 14 men's and women's tournament games set to be broadcast live on ESPN Digital Networks. For more information, visit SWAC.org. Presented by Buick.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Anthony Bates. Yes, it's Barnett. Not Barrett. How about that? We're going to change his name to Barnett. Shot his way. It's good now. The Tigers up by 364-61. JT Barrett done a great job. He's my student. Here we go. Left side. Payne puts it up off the glass. No. Waddle puts it back up. Where is the and one? No foul. And we're going back the other way. 64-61. And the long rebound to Bowler. Okay. Timeout by Coach Sandy Pugh. The Tigers now go up by a quick five here in the fourth quarter with 2 minutes left to play, man. Pugh drawing up a play. The Panthers doing really, really well here with a chance here. With a chance. Folks, don't forget, exciting Panthers softball comes your way this Wednesday as the Panthers take on the Quakers of Penn College, Pennsylvania College. Looking forward to seeing the Lady Panthers. Looking forward to see Eric Rojas out there and the whole crew. Be a lot of fun for softball season this year. Jada Bowen, wow. AKA, huh? All right, folks. Yeah, cut that one off. Let's get back to the game. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Down to 2 minutes left to play, 66-61. The Panthers down by five with the ball and in dire need of some points here. We got to get some points out of this one. Here comes Payne. Right side now to Roberson. Roberson looking for Smith. She's been hot. Down to 16 seconds. Plenty of time. Back over to J. Rob. Rob at the top of the key. Looking for Payne. Gives it up. Payne thought about the three-pointer. Steps inside. Now works on Luckett. Turns around. Gets it in the corner now to Smith. She's been hot. Hits the front of the iron. No. Can't find a shot. The Panthers steal it away. Over to Waddle. For two! Waddle puts it in. Now the Panthers down by three with some great defense. Great steal that time by Jayla Roberson to keep the Panthers alive after the missed shot. And Payne is fired up out there. Here we go. Folks, down to crunch time. A minute 22 left to play. The Panther faithful is on fire here in the Baby Dome. Here comes Luckett, right side. Roberson on her. Brings it to the left, going around the pick. Roberson stepping. Oh, and jumps into Roberson and draws the foul. Veteran play and a push. Well, I wouldn't call it a push, ref. That's not a push, but you're the official, whatever. A minute and 7 seconds left to play, 66-63. Foul on the floor. You said two shots. She wasn't shooting, was she? She's getting it on the floor? They're going to leave it to shoot it? Oh, they're in the bonus? Oh, the Panthers are in the bonus with five, so we'll be shooting two anyway. Luckett. See if we can't give her the old jinx. Luckett, 2-1. I just tried to throw something out there to try to throw her off. That's just two backwards. One of two was Luckett. Actually, I'm sadly mistaken. I'm just trying to jinx her. Okay, folks, I'll tell you the truth. Luckett is 7 for 7 from the charity stripe. Doing well. 68-63, a five-point lead. Come on, we've got to do something. Down 2 minutes left to play. We come across the timeline, and we're going to draw up a play here. Pugh wants the board. Well, folks, the Panthers have done exactly what their pregame plan was, and that's to rebound well, get to the bucket, play good heads-up defense, and for goodness sake, hit the shots in the paint. The Panthers have won the battle in the paint. We'll take our final break, ladies and gentlemen. 1 minute and 3 seconds left to play. The Panthers are down by five, 68-63. We'll be back with the final.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Ladies and gentlemen, Charles Porter, JT Barrett, along with Mia Greer, a.k.a. Me, the Panthers Sports Broadcast Team, doing it for you folks. Don't forget, join us this Saturday as the Panthers travel to the H&PE Arena down on the campus of Texas Southern to take on the Tigers of Texas Southern. That'll be our final basketball broadcast. We're excited about it, and great job of catching it. Here we go, right side now. The Panthers need a point here. They give it up to – oh, and a foul call, and that one has to go the other way. Inserted into the game, Mia Moore, the junior from Colorado City, Texas. Paul and B are listening to exciting Panther basketball. I tell you, Mia Monroe can shoot it. And – we need to Monroe's going to have to stay out because we need defense. Roberson with the steal, gives it up to Waddle. Timeout. What are we doing? What happened? Timeout? A 22 and then a foul on Mahoney. Yeah, Mahoney tries to get it back, and the Panthers will walk it down and have an opportunity. Mia Monroe is going to check into the game for the Panthers. Now for Kayla Smith, Monroe with that deadly three-point shot. One foul to give now, and the Tigers have one more foul to give. And here comes Prairie View A&M with the ball. Payne will get it. Monroe's going to stay on that wing, and Mahoney knows she can shoot it. Here comes Payne now back over to Roberson, down to 43 seconds left to play. Roberson with a roll with that off the glass for two. Roberson with a great drill drive. Down by three now, 68-65. The Panthers have got to do something here. 37 seconds left to play. Here come the Tigers down on the left side. Crump with it. Gives it up now to Luckett. Roberson working hard is going to commit the foul. Luckett perfect from the charity stripe. Down to 30 seconds. The Panthers down by three, 68-65. Trying to play spoiler to the Jackson State Tigers. Here comes Kayla Smith. Mia Monroe will take a seat. Monroe is going to be inserted for offense. Smith with the defense. We don't believe in moral victories, but I tell you, the Lady Panthers have played outstanding here tonight. 30 seconds left to play. Lucky on the line. Yeah, we jinxed her, baby. Shot is away. It's no good. 68-65. Luckett misses the free throw. Luckett will have one more shot. Luckett at the line. The Panther faithful. Shot is away. And she quiets the crowd. Here come the Panthers. We got to hurry. Down to 28 seconds left to play and a timeout. And we'll take it at half court. We're going to take it. Golly gee, we had to get it across. But now the Panthers will draw up a play. Great action here in the Nix Center. The Panthers, man, gee whiz, where has this been all year, man? The Panthers playing with a purpose. The officials getting the business over there on the sideline with the call. And they're going to look at it. I think they want to look at this one to see what happened. They're going to run over here to Danny. And we're going to bring this one to a full timeout so we can take a look at it, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around. We'll take another break and come back with more exciting Panther basketball as we take a look. Wait a minute. We're staying? Wait, we're going to stay? Well, she came over and said we were going to take a break. She tried to – well, I guess they can change their mind, right? Okay. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Down to 27 seconds left to play. Oh, my goodness. A lazy pass into Ryan Payne. And the Panthers turn it over with 25 seconds left to play. Wow. Well, we're just trying to find out what's going on here. Twenty-five seconds left to play here in this one. The Panthers down four, folks, 69-65. And man, an exhilarating contest. You know, Jackson State had a target on their back the entire season. They get everybody's A game, and they certainly got the Panthers' A game tonight. Luckett will take it out for Jackson State. Luckett throwing it up, giving it over now, and a quick foul. Roberson is going to have to foul Luckett. And that's going to do it for J-Rob. That's five. Here comes Soders for Roberson. Man, Papa Soders, it was rough. Well, that's okay. Now, the scenario is the Panthers have made the tournament, ladies and gentlemen. We need a couple of things to happen to, as far as where our seeding is. So it looks like we're going to drop to seventh place. We're in a tie, a two-way tie with FAMU, I think it is, at FAMU for second place. Let me get it right. I got my notes here. So we're in a two-way tie, yeah, with FAMU with a 7-9 record. So the Panthers are down six now here with 20 seconds left to play. And depending on what happens down to Texas Southern with Alcorn State, if TSU rallies and beat Alcorn State, we will solidify the sixth or seventh position. But we will be in Birmingham this year, the women's team. So hats off to the Lady Panthers overcoming a lot of adversity throughout the season to still make it to the tournament. And their final game here in the William Nix Center has been an exciting one. 71-65 the score. Seconds left in this one. Here comes Payne. Payne kicks it right side over to Bolton. Payne for three. It's off the mark, down to 14 seconds on the shot clock. Here comes a big foul on Smith, or pardon me, from Smith on Jackson. And 11 seconds left to play, 71-65, a six-point edge. We'll take the long walk down. Angel Jackson, pretty darn good from the free throw line. And the Panthers missed it by that much. Jackson shot his way, it's good. Andrew Jackson, the grad student, Richmond, California. Tamika did a lot of shopping in California. 8 players from Mississippi. Looks like the rest are from California. A couple, let's see. Wiggins. Let's see. Oakland. One from Louisville, Mississippi. And, yeah, just really only one player. 2 players from California. Everybody else is from Mississippi. Brinkley's from Ridgeland. Breland's from Wiggins. Roberts from Newton. Hickman also from Newton. White from Gulfport. Hunter from Louisville, Mississippi. Michaela Woods is from Pflugerville, Texas. Okay, so we've got an Ohio person, a Texas person, and 2 Californians. The rest from Mississippi. Well, we're looking at this one to try to find out if it's the Panthers' ball. 5/10 of a second left to play in this one, folks. For those of you who are watching on the Panther YouTube channel, the Prairie View University Panther YouTube channel, you're going to have to reload for the men's game. Rewind. She says rewind. Yeah, there you go. Looking, trying to figure out what's going on and what are they looking at? They're looking for the foul on Payne or what's going on? Here we go. Here comes, there's the foul. There's an arm wrapped around and the reach for Payne. 1.4. They're just trying to see how many seconds to put on the clock. 1.4. Yeah, 1.4 seconds left. We'll see. They're talking to JT. One more time. She wants another look at it. Lady Panthers have nothing to be ashamed of, man. We missed about 8 opportunities that should have been points. We missed, we had, what, 4 unforced turnovers in that cadre of turnovers. Let's see. 7. Well, at the 5:16 mark of the fourth quarter, the Panthers only had 7 turnovers. So we'll try to figure this one out. Still waiting. Don't forget exciting men's action coming your way immediately following this one. About 20 more minutes, folks. Got time to get a snack, one of those frosty things or something nice and ice cold. And get back to your TV sets, your computer screens, or your phones, whatever you're watching, however you're watching. And catch the men's action. It's going to be a late night here, Mia. The Prairie View A&M University relays are upon us, folks. March 22nd and 23rd here on the campus of Prairie View A&M. And then following that, a couple of weeks later, April 12th, the spring football game. A lot of anticipation for the spring football game. Man, we are going to do it big down here in Panther Land. Got Panther Plaza going on down in the tailgate area. It's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of booths, a lot of information down there. Some vendors are going to be out selling their various goods. We're going to have a lot of food trucks out here. It's going to be a festive atmosphere. That's the Prairie View University 24 spring game, 24-25 spring football game right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M. 0.5 seconds left. The Panthers will eventually drop this one by 10 via free throws. And, man, it's been tough. Well, my hats out to the Panthers, the number one team in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. The Jackson State Tigers come to town. And good sportsmanship. The Panthers, the Tigers know that they have been in the game. And exchanging pleasantries here. We'll see you down the road in the tournament. That's what the Panthers are saying. I agree. Tamika Reed, congratulations to her and the athletic program down at Jackson State University, they're doing a fine job. 35 minutes, folks. Get something to snack on. Get you a nice frosty thing. And then come on back down here for more exciting Panther basketball as the Jackson State Tigers are in town. This is exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.